Star Wars is massive, easily one of the biggest and most successful franchises of all time. Of course, being a franchise, the series naturally expanded into gaming. And through the years, we've seen a wide variety of Star Wars titles, ranging from Lego-themed action-adventure games, to racers, and every blockbuster Battlefront in between. However, with EA rekindling their desire to produce Star Wars titles across multiple genres, I thought that there was one genre in particular that they simply couldn't ignore. I'm not the first to suggest that a real-time strategy Star Wars game would be a good idea. In fact, multiple games of that genre have been developed before. The first of which was Star Wars Force Commander, released on PC in March 2000. This wasn't exactly a glowing example of the potential of the genre, critics highlighting the dated graphics and flawed controls. Yeah, to be honest, I don't blame them. Next came Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds, released a year later again on PC. Crucially, this was built on the same engine as the first two Age of Empires, which earned critical acclaim, and Galactic Battlegrounds was no different, praised for its fast-paced action and attention to detail. Unfortunately, we'd have to wait around 5 years for our last example of a Star Wars RTS, Empire at War. Empire at War once again only launched on PC, but what was presented to us is the quintessential Star Wars RTS, combining a linear campaign, sandbox-style galactic conquest, and a straightforward skirmish mode. As a Halo fan, I can see the similarities between this and Halo Wars. Both games came out during a period of experimentation for their franchises. Both contained similar gameplay, modes, mechanics, but with one key difference. Halo Wars got its modern-day sequel. Star Wars RTS fans have been left to contend with Empire at War since 2006. And that does bring me on nicely to what this new hypothetical Star Wars RTS would look like. Firstly, we need to establish the plot, setting, conflicts, etc. I mean, this is Star Wars, so to be honest, anything goes. But I'm sure you guys in the comments will have ideas as to what timelines and conflicts we could use. Secondly, let's make one thing clear. I think this can launch on both PC and the new generation of consoles. Halo Wars 2 is a perfect example of catering an RTS to both controller and mouse and keyboard, and there's no reason our Star Wars RTS couldn't do something similar. Next, let's talk about gameplay. Being a Star Wars game, there's a lot we can do. Air, land, and infantry units are there in abundance, not to mention the variety in locations and factions. In terms of modes, Empire at War did quite well with its variety. But there is once again a lot of potential. We can increase the player count past 4 players, and some sort of horde-style PvE mode could certainly work well, especially with co-op. Building troops, upgrading defenses, researching new abilities, ever-increasing AI difficulty, etc. Campaign would be your standard 15-hour max playthrough, and online multiplayer would combine casual modes with more hardcore ranked playlists, with an emphasis on maintaining the competitive aspects of the game as an esports title. It's actually surreal how this game builds itself. We're using fairly standard building blocks, RTS mechanics, Star Wars universe, console-friendly control scheme. It's really nothing new or innovative. It just shocks me that it's been 15 years since something like this was released. And whilst the market isn't huge for the RTS genre, combine the Star Wars brand with how loyal the Empire at War community has been, and this would sell better than expected, and develop a devoted and faithful following along the way. Not to mention how it would also be available on Game Pass with EA Play. So whilst EA and Star Wars are expanding their content ideas across the board, perhaps they should remember their RTS past, and develop a fresh title for its modern fanbase, because it's been too long since its last entry.